That's extreme physics. And tonight, there's a car up for grabs for our contestants. They are Bert from Bangor, Maddie from Moneymore, and Kathleen from Castle Rock. And here's your host, Isaac Neutron.
A thousand welcomes all, and what a show we have for you tonight. It's all about springs, and here's our very own bouncy little brain box, Dr. Rula.
Thanks, Isaac. Today, we will investigate the relationship between the extension of a spring and the applied force, or as it is otherwise known, Hooke's law.
Great stuff. You can hook up with me anytime. Spring into action, Dr. Rula.
Thank you, Isaac. For this experiment, we will require a steel spring, a 100-gram mass hanger with 10 100-gram masses, a retort stand, a boss and clamp, a G-clamp, a base clamp, a meter rule, an S-hook, a pointer, and some safety goggles. We set up our apparatus as shown in this diagram. We can find the initial length of the spring by measuring the pointer value on the meter rule. Record this initial length. Let this correspond to zero mass. We add 100 gram mass to the hanger and record the new reading of the pointer on the meter rule. This is the final length. We calculate the extension by subtracting the initial length from the final length. Record all results in a table and repeat the procedure by adding 100 gram masses in steps of 100 gram up to 1000 gram. Plot a graph of stretching force F on the y-axis against the extension E on the x-axis. The graph is a straight line through the origin, but then curves towards the end. The straight line through the origin means that the extension of the spring is directly proportional to the stretching force up to maximum force, known as the limit of proportionality. This is Hooke's law. Beyond this point, the graph curves. Stretching force and extension are no longer directly proportional.
Oh my word, that was a thing of great beauty. But now it's time to play Extreme Physics!
So we have the longest spring in the world right here in the studio. As you can see, its initial length is 150 centimeters. When we attach a one-ton car, it extends by 50 centimeters. Now, assuming that that's within its elastic limit, what will happen when we add two more identical cars? Will it extend by a further 50 centimeters, 100 centimeters, or 150 centimeters? Get it right, and you'll win an Extreme Physics model car.
So, Rula, how low will we go?
Well, we know that Hooke's law says that the extension and force are directly proportional, so it shouldn't be too difficult to work out.
3, 2, 1, go!
Kathleen from Castle Rock, what's your answer?
Is it 100 centimetres?
Rula, is she right?
If the extension for one tone is 50 centimeters, then the extension for an additional two tones will be an extra 100 centimeters. Yes, she's correct.
Well, that was exciting. So it's good night from everyone here at Extreme Physics. And remember, if it ain't fun,
it ain't physics.